Hi there. In this video, we're going to look at a scholarly journal article to see how it passes our checklist for evaluating sources. Our checklist is author, date published, publisher, and purpose, that is it scholarly or popular? Looking at the first checklist item, the author's names are clearly identifiable on the first page of the article. It includes their affiliation, that's who they work for, and in this case it's an academic institution, so that lends them some authority. So we can check off authors. The second item on our checklist is date published. In this article it's right at the very top of the page, but that won't always be the case. There are some dates over here, and that might be confusing, but we can see that the received, revised, and accepted dates are all earlier than the date this issue of the journal was published, so 2013 is the official publication date. That means that it's fairly recent and the information should be up to date. The third item on our checklist is publisher. The publisher should be clearly identifiable, as it is in this case with Mason Bright. Some publishers are more respected than others in their fields, and you will learn how to spot these as you progress through your degree. Asking your librarian for help is a great way of starting that process. The last checklist item is the purpose of the article. Is it for a scholarly or popular audience? A scholarly source is one written by experts in their fields, to be read by other experts, researchers, and students. A popular source is for general readers and not really suitable for academic research. One of the main ways to identify a scholarly journal article is by the structure. It should be laid out in a clear and quite detailed way. Let's have a look. The author, article title, and journal details, including name, volume, and pages, are all clearly visible on the first page of this article. Also note that the article title is a descriptive one. It clearly tells us what the article is about. The article itself is divided into sections that clearly indicate the contents. There's an abstract that summarizes the article, and there are keywords that describe the subjects that will be discussed within the article. Reading both of these helps us figure out if this is an article we'd like to explore further. Many scholarly sources now have a DOI, a digital object identifier. You will need this to reference the article if you use it in your research. It should also be on the first page of the article. Common section headings in journal articles are introduction, literature review, methods, results, discussion, and conclusion. There should also be in-text citations where the authors have cited the sources that they have used. Figures and tables are often seen in scholarly sources. And there's a reference list. This is a full listing of the in-text citations that illustrates the sources the author has used to back up their research. All of these elements clearly indicate that this is a scholarly source, and that means that this article checks all the right boxes and would be a good source to use in our research.